So you want to know about the Smite 2017 Odyssey, huh? Well, you've come to the right place. Welcome to my Everything You Need to Know guide. This is a very common type of video within the YouTube world, but I decided to do it for the Odyssey specifically. I've had a lot of people asking me, Rain Day, make a video about the Odyssey. I'm new and I don't know anything about it or how to participate or what it really even is. So I'm going to spend time on this video giving you a very brief yet detailed and thorough enough explanation of what the Odyssey is. And so by the time you're done watching this video, you will know what you need to do to participate in the Odyssey. So obviously, if you're a beginner, that's perfect. And if you're a veteran, then this will still help you to clarify what differences there are in this year's Odyssey versus last year's. So first thing to note is that the Odyssey is not a game mode. It's not something you actually have to go and click in to do. It's simply an event, and it will symbolize the fact that a lot of cool skins are coming your way. And these skins are going to be based on the Pantheon, so the Japanese, Egyptian, Hindu, Norse, Roman, all of those will have different skins, and different characters from those pantheons will be highlighted. We don't know which ones will be highlighted until they announce it in the patch before it releases. So that's kind of what the anticipation is. Will your favorite god get a skin? That's one of the things that's really exciting about this time. So it's not a game mode. It's not Jing Chan's Mountain. It's not something you're going to have to click on like Clash or Arena. It is literally just an event that symbolizes that this has begun. The awesome skins have pretty much begun. And there's a lot more than skins too. There are icons, there are really cool chest roll that have various things and like borders, and of course all of this is for a point. And the point is to unlock the tier 5 Anubis skin for this year. Now, last year it was a tier 5 Thor skin, and it was a very cool skin and something that really allowed a lot of people to say, you know what, I want to commit fully to this Odyssey, because there are things you have to do in order to get that skin. And this year it's going to be a little different in that requirement category. But that is okay, because a lot of the ways you get the skin are actually rewards themselves. So you end up having to purchase really cool skins on the way to get an even cooler skin. It's not that bad of a deal. Alright, so let's say I buy two of the new skins and I buy an icon that they're selling for the Japanese Pantheon. This is hypothetical. I don't think they're actually selling a Japanese icon. If I buy that, then I would get, hypothetically, 3 levels out of the 21 that I need in order to complete the Odyssey. And if I did that 6 more times, I would get 21 levels and I would unlock the tier 5 Anubis skin. Now, this is pretty much how the Odyssey has worked since they started doing it. But this year, they've decided to introduce something which I like a lot, which is the ability to complete quests instead of having to gain each level through purchasing items. Because the truth is, inevitably, there's gonna be that Gnome Ward skin. Yeah, that's right, that Gnome Ward skin that you don't want to get. You're like, I don't wanna spend money on this, but I want that Anubis skin. How can I get past this level? Well, you can complete these quests, and if you complete 7 quests within the period that essentially, you know, say the Japanese Pantheon is going for this time period, if you complete all 7 quests during that time, you will then get an extra level, and you can actually get 4 levels just by completing quests. That way you don't have to spend your money or your gems on 4 items that you don't like. And along the way, you'll get free bonus chests that you can roll and get random items on, and it's pretty cool. You get a lot of free stuff by just purchasing the Odyssey items. And maybe some of you are saying that I don't really care about the bonus stuff, I don't really care about the skins, I just want the tier 5 Anubis skin. And a lot of people are really doing it for that. It's gonna be some buku bucks to finish this entire thing, so you gotta be committed. Do you really want that Anubis skin? And if you do, then it's pretty easy. You're just gonna buy everything you need to get there, or maybe complete 4 levels, so you only gotta buy, you know, 17 levels worth of items and skins versus doing it all. And trust me, you're gonna want that tier 5 skin. We haven't seen it. We don't know any of the graphics or the animations, but it's gonna be amazing. And pretty much Archon Thanatos, the first tier 5 skin they made, was so coveted, people are willing to pay almost whatever for that skin. I'm talking thousands of dollars, like money, to get that skin, because they just missed out and there's no way to get it, and it's just a cool thing to have. You can't pay too much to be cool, am I right? So what are you paying for when you're doing the full Odyssey? Well, you're paying for the tier 5 skin, really. But the benefit of that is, if there are 6, 7, 8, even, hey, let's say 15 15-17, let's hope for the best, right? Skins that you absolutely love and you would have bought anyway. If there are skins that you would have gotten anyway, that'll give you a level right there, and it just makes it a little easier on your conscience, like, okay, yeah, I was gonna buy that skin. I would have bought that skin anyway. Now I can just buy, you know, a few more and I get the Anubis skin. Yeah, it's worth it. That's what makes the Odyssey great. Usually they have some of the best skins they've had all year, maybe even ever. I remember Base Drop Janus. That's still one of my favorite skins, and that was from last year's Odyssey. So when they put out cool skins like that that you want anyway, and it also contributes to the fact that you're gonna get closer and closer to that tier 5 Anubis skin, pretty much at a certain point you're just like, all right, I gotta buy out, you know, 4 items. Cool, let's do it. And to recap, this year you have a special way to actually gain levels, which could mitigate 4 items that you don't like, and you can gain those levels instead by completing 7 of the quests during that patch where we're featuring a Pantheon. So during the Japanese Pantheon, go ahead and complete those 7 quests and get yourself a free level. Thanks for watching. If you have questions, go to the website linked in the description below and feel free to comment them, even though I feel like this should handle all of your questions. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and as always, remember to never give up, never stop gaming, and I'll see you all next time.